Yeah, so my keynote speech was about future of myeloma, meant to be futuristic. I restricted to within the time frame that we would see. And the main theme was how what we are doing currently in the lab is going to transform how myeloma would be diagnosed and treated. And the areas I covered, and I think were very pertinent, is that in future, probably we may not need to do the bone marrow. We can take a blood sample. We would be able to look at circulating DNA, which we do already today as an experimental basis. But circulating DNA would identify myeloma. It would also identify the subtype of myeloma, just using blood and the serum. Using the same blood sample, we can then isolate myeloma cells from the blood. There's always a circulating myeloma cells in the blood. The current technology exists to do it. In 20, 30 years, it would have much more perfected. And that will give me the phenotype of the myeloma cells. Then the third step is, can we take the same blood sample or the myeloma cells and determine what drug a patient is going to respond to? And there was, I presented a data on a new technology that we have developed with our colleagues at MIT, where we can do single cell mass measurement. We can measure the mass of a single myeloma cell, and we can look at the change in mass in real time over 4 hours. And when the cells are exposed to drugs, the mass changes. And that tells us quite reliably, as our data shows, whether that myeloma cell is going to respond to treatment or not. And because it's single cell, we can look at 400, 500 cells and see how many cells would respond, whether a patient will get a partial response or a full response. And then based on those information, in 20 or 30 years, we may be able to pick the right drugs. And then finally, I gave a little glimpse of what the new treatments might be available. And one of the examples, again presented at an early stage, are called degranulamids, where there are chemicals combined that can then lead to targeted destruction of a given protein. So instead of using a drug that will otherwise will have to work through the whole mechanism, we can get a targeted destruction. So I can target MYC, I can target RAS, or I can target whatever other gene we need to target. And those degranulamids are one of the futures of the field. Also talked very briefly about CAR T cells. That's another new biologically driven treatment that is a great future for this disease. Our early study shows outstanding response in very advanced patient population. So that's going to be important. And the final part was that once we have treated myeloma and gotten rid of it, we still need to fix whatever damage myeloma did. So there is some effort in doing mesenchymal stem cell transplant. We can make the microenvironment normal, maybe heal the bone lesions, etc. And there is some advances in that field which is happening. So combination of diagnostic techniques, the therapeutic advances, and then supportive care, in 20 or 30 years would not only cure myeloma, but make patients' quality of life back to normal.